get abducted by the crew of the starship Alpha 2. They're from the planet Q, which, due to a space-time loop, is stuck in 82 and must be rescued. They need our heroes to discuss the latest news and give their reviews of games and movies, too. Sure hope you're not confused. We swear this is all true, not just the premise to The Totally Rad Show.
Hey everybody, welcome to The Totally Rad Show, episode number 17. I'm Alex Albrecht.
I'm Jeff Cannata.
I'm Dan Trachtenberg, and we are now legally allowed to go see an R-rated movie.
Ha ha! That's
awesome. Next week, cool. You'll be able to have sex with us.
I know
Jeff's like, I've been waiting!
You know what's cool?
Yes, we can vote.
E3 week, which is why we have a video game themed background
or
from Josh.
Epic Cubed week. Which I'm a little disappointed. My buddy was in town, my guy from Pandemic, Dave Rosen, he sent me a text message, and I was like, the one guy I didn't ask to see if we could get an invite to E3 was the guy who runs marketing for Pandemic.
Wow. I'm actually glad that we didn't go.
Really?
Because I feel like we wouldn't have been able to see everything.
Well,
there was so, this it was the spread, first time it was so in 6 years out. I haven't gone.
Me
but
too.
And I'm so sad.
But it's
me
so
too.
Spread out. And like to have
yeah, this year's much more spread out.
If we had gone, we would have had to go to one thing and miss two.
Plus,
others,
I hate to say it, but we're the people they didn't want going. Just guys who were like, I want to pay everything. That's stupid. I want to go to this one. It's stupid. Because I was talking about this where like a 10% done game, a developer can go in and be like, well, this is going to be really good. And then these guys go, it doesn't work. Yeah.
We'll
and then blog about it. That was stupid.
We'll see. Yeah.
And then it crushes people.
We'll see when we do our segment. If maybe
totally. But we do want to thank Josh Estes for giving us the background days.
It's kind of video game themed. Yeah. I have two predictions for the video game segment this week.
Yes.
It's going to be long.
And I'm going to sweat.
That's a prediction of this segment, the next segment, the segment after that.
It's hot.
Well, we're balls deep in
the
valley.
But at least there probably won't be crickets. So everybody should be pleased about that.
Yeah, it was hot enough to kill all the crickets.
It is Southern California, and we do have
fruit flies. Let's get into it.
So, for movies, this week we saw Harry Potter and the Order of the Phoenix.
Bingo, broke the Wednesday record for most money made in history.
Did it? How much money?
$44.5 million.
Wow, really?
Yeah, beat Spider-Man 2, which was 42,
I
think.
Yeah, I was just going to say.
Wow. Yeah.
Interesting.
Owns the record now.
Well, this may help Alex out on your summer
I
major.
Hope so.
You need this. So, I'm sure you guys are going to geek out a little bit.
You're not a Potter guy.
I read the first book. That's it. That's my relationship with Harry Potter. I enjoyed the movies. I did not enjoy the last one. I really liked the first three. I really liked the third one.
It was the darkest of the...
Well, maybe the last one.
So
I thought
far. No.
But this one, I
this one
thought,
is now the darkest.
Yes,
this clearly.
One, I really enjoyed it.
This movie opens up like 28 days later.
The opening is
I
fantastic.
I was like, what the hell movie
so
is this? Yeah,
and it's very, it's so much more.
vomit.
Hello.
Maybe it's more flies.
It's so much more real and natural than the others. And but not done in a. It didn't have to do it gritty and to be real. It just felt more real. The performances were better, I thought.
Yeah.
It sort of shed the Spielbergian awe that the first two had.
But don't you think that I think that made it have a kind of a dour tone to it? Like there's
well, the book has a dour tone.
It does. It's actually my least favorite of the books. This one. Is my least favorite of the book.
Interesting.
But
three
I like
is
the
my
movie.
Favorite. Three is my favorite.
Let me just finish.
Go ahead.
Let me just lead into you guys and say if you haven't watched any of the other movies, this is going to do nothing for you. You have no business watching it. It's very inside baseball as far as... That's fine.
Who's going to go see the fifth Harry Potter
movie? That's true, although, I mean...
It's like playing Resident Evil 5 and being like, I don't know the character.
My only thing about that is that I feel very strongly that you could watch Return of the Jedi having not seen the first two and be fine. I don't think that this is very
interesting.
Not pure. And the first two Harry Potters, I think you could have seen either of those two and still enjoy it. They're they're more like pure story, and this is just very plot heavy. Although
that's how the book is like.
The book is this here, is let's
the,
get to
this is just yes exactly. Yeah. This is also the MacGuffin okay. in this one, yeah. which is that prophecy. It's a completely arbitrary, and yeah. it doesn't have any yeah. impact on anything ever. It gets destroyed, right?
Yeah.
Spoiler just to give one more plus for me on this movie is that the last one felt the same way,
yeah.
but it just felt like it was just trying to get through the story. There was nothing really cool happening.
Yeah.
This one, I really felt like the director paid attention to details, made all those details really fun and interesting. Yeah. It was very enjoyable to watch. Even like the placards that they put on the wall
yeah.
and the way that they're written, they're just little detail. It's like, oh, this is cool. This is fun. Yeah.
And
moments felt good.
Yeah.
And how amazing is Imelda Staunton?
Yes.
She's amazing.
I hate that.
Her
kind of
and
villain.
Alan Rickman, they can do no wrong as far as I'm concerned.
Well, also, I mean, the cast's epic. You know what I mean? Like, the cast is always.
And how great is it that they set out to make 7 movies with one cast? Like, when has that ever happened before?
Yeah.
Like, we're going to set out to make 7 films. 7 feature-length films, high budget. Here we go. Let's roll.
Yeah.
You know? That's pretty amazing.
Well, they knew. Star Trek.
But they didn't set out to do that. First one was like, they didn't do seven.
They did six. 6 was the last one with all of them, right?
There you go.
Discover Country. Boom. My favorite one.
So that's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
So I'm going to say this was probably my favorite Potter movie.
Oh, wow.
I was surprised as well. I thought that they nailed so much more of the feeling of the magic world than the other ones. I always felt a little bit like, so you can like flick wands out of people's hands. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
But dude,
wizard on wizard action.
Dude, Aurors versus Death Eaters, hot.
Not since Egg Shen v Lo Pan. Have we seen magic battles
dude,
like this?
But I will say, the wand duel at the end, and shot.
And you know why?
Amazingly, the sound effects.
Joseph
dude,
Fiennes, his performance when he does magic.
Ray
he
Fiennes,
is,
not his brother.
Oh, it's Ray Fiennes?
It's Ray Fiennes.
Oh, right. Okay. Getting confused.
Yeah, that's okay. Well, he doesn't look like Ray Fiennes.
Wait, he looks
like
Snake
Man.
Boy.
He
shall not be named.
Yes.
When he does magic, it's like doing magic, you know?
Yeah.
He is doing it.
Yeah.
It's
and even
really
the way
evocative.
He holds his wand, he just nails the scary thing. But when they have that epic battle and they're using all the different elements, like, you know, you get to see the inside of the Ministry of Magic for the first time. And they nailed
great
it.
Great, so cool looking.
It's so like, that is where I believe wizards would go to work. You know what I mean? Like, you're just like, I'm a wizard, I gotta go to work. You know, this is where
I like the movie a lot too, and I think it might have something to do with how long it's been since I read that book. I think I didn't like the earlier Harry Potter movies because I read the book really close to when I saw the movie, and all I could see was where it didn't live up to the book.
Up the book. Yeah.
I think a lot of the stuff has faded into my memory, and I was able to sort of come in with fresh eyes and see this movie because I do remember thinking this was the weakest of the books, and I think I agree with you. I think it's maybe the strongest of the movies, and I think the reason for that is that
and Helena Bonham Carter as Bellatrix Lestrange.
She's scary, dude.
All those Death Eaters, I was like, that is what I thought they would be like.
I think the reason for that is what you're talking about with the fights between. The movie fills in what the book couldn't possibly, rather than trying to just hit all the beats of the book.
Yeah.
It leaves out a lot of stuff, you know. But where it fills in is sort of the visual stuff that's fun to watch. I mean, there's no Quidditch in the movie at all. You know, it's really kind of dour, and everything is really kind of.
Wasn't
dark
there,
and depressing
what
and not.
Quidditch stuff was going on in 5?
Well, there's like a whole Quidditch subplot in.
And there was no. There were, yeah, there's
they don't
not
even.
Much
as far as you can tell from this movie, they
Gryffindor,
don't even play this year.
Yeah. Wow, that totally did. Anyway, but that proves a point. I didn't notice that.
Yeah.
I didn't even think about that. And I mean, Harry Potter equals Quidditch. You know what I mean?
There's one thing that I feel like these movies missed that this almost brought to it.
Yeah.
This one started to explain the magic a little bit more, and you saw how they had to train it.
Well, read the books.
It felt a little bit more logical. Yeah. But
that's
well,
what
I guess
the, books are for,
the
right,
movies,
man.
The movies, to me, feel like they missed the mark. I feel like there's such an opportunity to make magic about like your soul, like kind of like the forces, and make it mean more something.
You mean talk about the metachlorians?
But
that's
not talk about the force.
That's not what magic is in the Potter universe. Magic is something you learn out of a book.
Why is one guy better at it than another guy just because he does this better? Like, I kind of want to dive into...
Which is why
Rudy, you know, he's still playing football. You learn football by playing whatever. It's all a technical thing, but It's about your heart, you know? And I feel like they never put that into these movies. And I feel like that's the stuff that would really hit me.
I think they try to get it in there with the whole fact of, like, why Harry is so powerful over Voldemort is because of the, you know, like, the love of his parents protected him in the beginning. And they've talked about this in all the other movies and stuff like that. And so, I mean, they talk a little bit about that. I love those, the dead horses that you can only see.
There's a special name for those things.
Yeah, it's like Pelicatronic. Oh, yeah. But it's also such a great callback and good for, you know, Miss J.K. Rowling's. It was like, you know, those, at first it was just epic that those carriages flew by themselves.
Right.
And that was like an epic moment in one of the books. And then now we come back and realize, well, you thought it was epic, but you really don't even know what it was that it was invisible dead horses that only people who have seen death can see were pulling it. So it was like epic when they first showed it, and then they re-epified
That's
it.
That's cool. So re-epified.
Yeah.
News.
Awesome.
They want to remake Footloose.
Who's the they in the sentence?
Why do they keep remaking stuff?
The they is Zac Efron from...
spit his name out of your mouth.
Zac Efron from High School Musical.
Yeah. Oh, no.
And he's been Hairspray and the director of High School Musical.
So they're going to make a Disney version of Footloose?
This is terrible. Footloose, to me, is a freaking great movie.
I agree.
Let the kids dance, Dan.
Footloose, they want to make it a musical.
Dude, the first time I ever saw anybody do a flip, and I wanted to do it myself.
But, like, Footloose is one of those movies for me that is about, like, the most important stuff. Like honestly.
Freedom.
Honestly,
socks.
Like
dancing around in them.
Magnolia. Graffiti. Or not graffiti. What's that?
Slamming a wall as you're walking down the street.
Magnolia. Babel. All those movies that are about, like, the underlying things in life. Like, Footloose is about that to me.
Yeah, what you can do in an iron forge without when nobody's there.
No, but it's so much more profound than that. And, like,
I agree.
Preacher's daughters
and
are usually hot.
And that argument, the conflict between the preacher, and that everything is so representative of so much more, and I love that movie, and it's fun too. Yeah. It's just a perfect movie to me.
And you're just certain they're gonna ruin it.
And I don't think it's. And I think it's classic. I think there's things in it that date it. Obviously, we're making fun of those things right now.
Well, yeah.
But it just bums me out. It's not gonna be. I mean, you know, with One Saving Grace, this guy directed and choreographed Newsies, which is a fucking badass
movie. Christian Bale's first movie?
Yeah, dude, so good. Actually, not his first movie.
Well, no, but...
Empire of the Sun.
I worked with a guy who was in Newsies, was one of the kids in Newsies.
So good, that movie.
Yes, Christian
Bale. Anyway, but I don't...
I never mentioned it before because I didn't think it was impressive.
When we were talking about Batman and all that stuff.
You know, High School Musical has become such a phenomenon.
Yeah.
I'm actually a big fan. I've watched it a million times.
I've never seen it.
But it's good because it's bad. I feel like they really think they made a real. They made, talking about kids movies last week. They made a straight up kids teeny bopper movie.
Well, it's like a. I mean, it was Disney's. It's not transcendent of that movie at all.
Right?
Yeah, right.
But I feel like they are not aware that it's not transcendent.
So you're worried they're gonna do the same thing, and it's just gonna look like a kids version of Footloose.
Oh. Well, yeah. Obviously, it will look like that.
Well, no, but you know, I mean, just because they did that doesn't mean they're gonna look at Footloose, and they can make you know, Footloose the freaking Fight to the Death movie if they wanted to, but you're just saying...
So you think it's going to be more like Footloose and Fancy Free?
Yes. That is what I'm saying.
That's good. That's
I went
good
there. I can make your heart beat short.
I can make you ice cream. Dude, the ice cream man just showed up, so we're going to get some ice cream. Dude, first off, classics, popsicles, anything popsicle. Dude, Star Wars
popsicles? Dude, strawberry shortcake?
This is my favorite.
I'm gonna have to borrow money.
I think that's my.
I will get you your money.
I wish they had Otter Pops. I could go for like six to
strawberry
eight Otter Pops.
Or the chocolate eclair thing. I'm a strawberry shortcake guy.
That's not chocolate eclair. The other thing's chocolate eclair. This is a different, a different brand.
Oh, that's a different brand. Okay.
Micro flavored ice cream. I'm
gonna do a choco taco.
I feel like I want something not as sweet.
Choco taco.
Nothing says.
That sounds
nothing
disgusting.
Says summertime like
a
ice cream.
Taco.
Man.
Anybody
I don't know what this is. Why is it
taco?
Shaking?
I don't know. I'm gonna get just like a pop. Dude, he has toys in here.
A samurai sword.
That's what bros are for.
Ice cream.
Bros
buy your stuff.
Ice cream bros.
Right? What'd you get? Would you get Big Stick Popsicle?
Big Stick Popsicle. No. It's called Pop.
It's so hot.
What?
Thank you, Ice Cream Man.
This is good. It looks a little wrong right now. But it's so right.
Suck
it does have ridges. It's ripped for her.
This is how I eat my taco.
Oh.
I don't get brain freeze. I get like my teeth chill.
Yeah, it's called bad teeth.
Good times.
All right, it was E3 week, and there's a lot to cover.
Lots.
So we're going to try to go through each of the big three press conferences and kind of cover what they talked about, the big announcements.
Yes.
First one was Microsoft.
Yes.
It was clear from the Microsoft press conference that what they were focusing on big time was this year. They didn't show anything that's coming out for the 360 that's not going to be coming out this Christmas season.
Yeah.
This holiday season.
That's really cool.
Which is an interesting take. I don't think it was the right take to take.
Really?
Clearly they want people to buy.
How many takes does it take to make the right take?
Well, clearly for us, two.
I think three, actually.
I believe it's three.
Yeah.
I think that that what they're trying to do is have everybody run out and buy a 360 this year and say, hey, let's capitalize on our lead over the PS3.
Smart.
And see if we can. They legitimately have a stellar
amazing
Christmas
games that are coming out. Yes.
Let's talk about some of those games.
What's the game that you'd like to talk about, Dan?
Oh, boy. You know, honestly, this is grouping everything together, but what I was so, for some reason, really impressed by was the arcades, the downloadable games for both PS3 and Microsoft. And
interesting.
The Xbox Live Arcade, they just streamed through a billion of the games.
Yeah.
One of them that caught my eye was Wing Commander Arena or something.
Yeah, I've heard very bad things about that game.
But still, Wing Commander?
The possibilities.
Oh, my God.
If it rapes your childhood remembrance of Wing Commander. It's a 2D Wing Commander.
But that's what Wing Commander...
No, Wing Commander is you go in 3D.
No, that's what they showed. I thought it's a little
2D plan.
And there's some game called like Geon or something that looked cool.
I don't know.
They just raced through a bunch of games.
Golden Axe?
Yeah, Sega's bringing out a whole bunch of classics.
Yeah, but some of like, the new like geometry, like new games being made for it looked
really
cool.
Well, like
Calling
All Cars that we loved for the
PS3.
No, but I mean like those are games that you can make a small game, Xbox Live Arcade sees. Let's make a game. What the hell?
Okay.
Isn't that what they make with the package? They have like the package you buy.
Totally Rad Show the game. Get on it.
Anyway, as far as the big games, Call of Duty 4 did look...
Call of Duty 4
blew my mind.
It was everything that I didn't think the game was going to be. You know how I was always like, I love the sort of like you're the one guy, you have friends, they're telling you what to do, you know where you're going to go, you try to do, and I was like, it's not going to be, it's just going to be, you know, freaking Rainbow Six or whatever, Ghost Recon. Totally wrong. Loved it. When the freaking, it says like, follow Captain McCloud or whatever,
and he just stands up, and he's been
lying there in
camouflaged.
His ghillie sack the whole time. I was like,
when you're crawling on the grass and the focus
is out,
oh
I knew you'd love
God.
That. As the leaves went by, I was like, Dan likes that this are out of focus.
But it was
that game looks
so
epic, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Amazing.
It's Infinity Ward. It's the guys who did Call of Duty 2, not the guys who did Call of Duty 3.
Amazing.
I'm gonna repeat myself later, but when I at every press except for the Nintendo one, like at the Xbox stuff, I wanted to buy an Xbox again.
Yeah.
Like I
yeah.
was so pumped. I watched these conferences.
We bought
I watched
your first
conference.
One.
I know. I bought, and thank you very much. I appreciate it. Thanks.
Yeah, no problem.
I watched this at midnight. I thought I'd just watch an hour and fall asleep.
Yeah.
I was up till like 4 a.m. I could not fall asleep. I was so
pumped.
Oh,
that's
so
what that email was? Where you were like, holy crap, watch anything.
I could not stop. It was amazing.
So what about like Mass Effect?
Yeah, this is cool.
Yeah, I'm going to
really?
Say I'm not as blown away as Mass Effect. Because for me, the graphics aren't as...
Are you kidding?
Yeah, I'm seriously. There's so many... There's like Jack
I mean, I think... I just said everything looked amazing. And I wanted everything.
Yes.
But to really get into it...
And
I've
been waiting
I don't know
for,
what's
Mass Effect is RPG. It's way RPG.
But it doesn't seem like an RPG. The
fighting, the fighting is almost Gears of War-y. It's like
Gears
it's
of War meets
person.
KOTOR meets.
Yeah, exactly.
So what's the RPG on this? Just that you have
some
stats,
sort of thumb.
Worlds to go explore, tons of side quests, epic storyline.
It's pretty cool.
It's
I think
gonna
I'm gonna,
be
I think
amazing.
Now I'm gonna say I think I'm gonna. This is gonna be my favorite game of history. But I just, watching the trailers, I'm like,
Well,
especially, you watch Assassin's Creed, you watch the gameplay of Assassin's Creed, then you watch Mass Effect, and I'm like,
I actually disagree with you. I was disappointed by what I saw with Assassin's Creed.
Why?
Really?
I really
why?
Was. It looked, well,
I love this. This, is, why
so
we, this is why
close,
we do the show, people.
It's so close to being released, and the frame rate was really bad. And I like he's running up to those. There's like all these people with pots in their head. And they kept running up to him, and they drop the pot, and he run up to the next one, and knock into him, and they drop the pot.
And I was like, pots.
That.
it's a lot of pod people.
Not realistic in any way. I don't know. I think the game's going to be awesome. I want it to be awesome. The chase stuff was fun.
When he was doing the free parkour, the parkour stuff
was like...
That makes me excited about that first-person parkour.
Maybe, I don't know.
Prince...
No, I agree.
Yeah, but that's awesome.
That's it, what I was potentially saying, be very
cool. I think it's going to be cool. I think what they showed made me go...
But I like that it's Prince of Persia with an open world where I can do like almost like Tony Hawk. Like I can like come up with cool stuff.
Well, when he was standing on his little perch, you know, a little gremlin-esque.
And then he jumps off the thing and lands into the hay, and she goes, luckily nobody saw that. And I was like...
I think she was actually, because I saw an interview later today, she was making a joke like...
You're talking about my future wife, Jade Raymond?
I'm sure her husband has things to say about that. Is she married? I don't know, but I can't imagine that she's hot. And
Assassin's Creed.
But
that would be awesome if you just showed up and be like, I'm doing what you told me to do through the game, right?
There was also a glitch.
That's because it might happen.
There's another glitch in the game. She said, yeah, I just put a call. Well, we fixed them by the month.
Clearly.
The game is still in development.
I agree.
Well, but we have Resident Evil 5 and Halo 3 to talk about.
Along with everything in the universe that's coming out in November. Yeah. It's going to be like the end of my
but
wallet.
The thing about Mass Effect, segue into this, is that the thing I didn't like about Mass Effect was that the world doesn't, I feel like this is just such a world that we've seen a million times, and it felt very much like the Halo world. It just felt very like
Halo world.
Like staple sci-fi.
Yeah.
What did you think of the Halo 3 trailer?
Way more exciting than the Halo 3 multiplayer stuff. I mean, it looked like if it's co-op, if they have co-op, online co-op with that, dude, what? Like getting a little side thingies.
I hope COD 4 has co-op.
Yeah, I hope so too.
I really need everything to be co-op from now on. Otherwise, I'm a little bit
bummed. Three-player co-op at the minimum.
Yeah, somebody please get on the three-player co-op for the Totally Rad Show.
But you know, there's tons of
four-player co-op.
Steve is
actually Rainbow Six did, but it's
All the stuff with Halo 3 where it, clearly you're playing alongside the Arbiter.
Yeah,
I think it's gonna be like Gears of War where
you want. Yeah.
I think so.
So that definitely got me more excited.
I wasn't pumped.
I think the
I wasn't either.
Well, no. Let me. My next statement was, I think I'm tired of the Halo universe. I'm kind of done. Yeah. Because as cool as all the... I was more excited about this than I was the Halo 3 multiplayer, but I was really not excited about the Halo 3 multiplayer.
Right.
So this was just a little bit more excited than zero excitement.
Yeah.
I'm not all that excited about getting this game.
Me neither. And I'm going to get it. I'm going to play through it.
Of course.
It'll probably be really fun.
Of course. But I'm a little bit like Microsoft... is kind of, you know, masturbating itself a little bit by just going, Halo 3, Halo 3. Whoa, look how great. And I'm like, no, work on some of the other games because they're just as impressive. BioShock is way more impressive right now than any of the crap I've seen about Halo 3.
Yeah.
Even Mass Effect. COD 4 blows Halo 3 out of the water.
I agree. So what about Resident Evil 5?
I didn't see any of that.
But it was just...
I'm excited to play
one. I mean, the trailer was awesome. But
amazing.
I don't know.
Yeah. It's crazy.
I didn't know what to get from that, though, you know, other than
just
it looks
disturbing
cool.
And very different
zombie
from anything
disease,
I've ever done.
Probably.
Why different, though?
It's like Somalia. In the sun, like baked sun, kind of Somalia, Africa, where I don't know where it is specifically, but it looked like impoverished third world kind of
like City of God
very
with zombies.
Disturbing. Yeah.
Nice. City of God with zombies. Hello. Yeah. Yes.
City of goddamn zombies. Let's move on to Nintendo.
Yes.
Nintendo was the second press conference.
Yeah.
And they unleashed a torrent of announcements. Not.
With like two.
They announced Wii Fit.
Oh my God! I just talked about this on Dignation, and Kevin was excited because it was for the Wii and something he could buy. And I think
he wants to do hula hooping.
Right?
And
I think this is stupid. He was like, "You could do push-ups," and I was like, "I can do fucking push-ups on the floor.
I don't need
a little guy going onesie, twosie, threesie."
A couple of episodes ago, you went on record saying Wii like is not for gamers.
Yes, yes.
And you got a shit ton of complaints. We all kind of defended the Wii, and then Nintendo has this press conference, and basically what they walk out on stage and say is, "We agree with Alex." You know, they're basically saying
all the stuff that I saw on the coverage of it was everyone was having the same exact debate that we had on the stage.
Dude, and you know what? We did it 2 weeks ago. Just saying. This
Galaxy,
is why you gotta be.
Mario Galaxy
looks
awesome.
Amazing. Even Metroid 3 looked really cool.
But let me ask you a question about Metroid
3. I don't
want
to play it. No, I was watching it and I was like, how do you even? And then he's like,
it can be very cool. I want to ask you guys a question about Mario because they introduced
this
Wii Zapper thing, which is supposedly like exactly what you said last week when you're like, oh, what will happen with E3? Oh, maybe the Nintendo will have some sort of thing that will be like Time Crisis, and it's exactly what happened, right?
Yeah.
But and so they're saying, well, revolutionize the first person shooter because you'll be able to do this shit. But then
It's not supported in Metroid. Yeah. They're preeminent first-person shooter. Yeah, what the hell?
Well, they want Duck Hunt. That's it. They literally put the Duck Hunt visors on and said, if we make Duck Hunt again, people will love us.
Do you think that the Wii Zapper thing is cool?
No.
Do you think the Wii Fit is cool?
Super Scope 16.
Did anything that happened in the Nintendo press conference make you want to get a Wii?
No.
We agree that it was preaching to a different audience. It was going after soccer moms. It was going after all the people. But that's kind of your point.
Yeah, I was like, go for it.
They totally glossed over Galaxy. Like, Galaxy looks awesome.
That was
totally
the thing that got me super excited. The B thing.
That looks kind of rad.
It looks really rad, but that...
Oh, yeah, the wheel, by the way. We didn't talk about the Mario Kart and the wheel.
Garbage.
Wheel. I didn't see the wheel.
Okay, let's move on to Sony.
You put the controller... I like the idea, the way it connects. Yeah.
But it doesn't attach to anything. You're just holding it in the air?
Oh, I'm sure they'll come out with the stand for the wheel.
Well, I don't know.
I wonder if that's easier.
Let's move on to Sony.
Is it called a wheel? Like W-I-I?
That should be.
Oh, if it's not, it
the
will be.
The wheel? We reinvented the wheel. Or the wheel.
You need to work in marketing.
I should work in marketing.
Sony. Sony got
GameCube guts.
Sony.
I will say right now.
You're buying a PS3.
I want a PS... Dude, I literally almost... You have no idea. I went on Best Buy. I mean, I was going to go out that night.
I have to say something. I have to say something before we start.
Because of all these games that don't exist.
Wait, I have to say something.
I know. Well, that's why I didn't
get it. I have to say something.
Yeah. They've already...
I have to say thank you to everybody in the forums who told me about the 30-day price match guarantee on Amazon.
Oh, yes.
Because I got my $100 rebate.
And awesome.
I,
nice.
I would never have known to even ask for it if it wasn't for our forums, so thank you guys.
That's why fans rock.
So, anyway. You love it.
Dude. I mean, like I said...
Wait, take grains of salt here, people. They showed a game that they showed 2 years ago.
So what?
I'm just saying.
Well, why?
Well, I'm maybe not that mad game won't come people. Out for 2 years.
I want to play those games.
Saying, yeah, but I'm saying. This is what they did 2 years ago.
What?
You wanted to play Killzone 2 2 years ago as well.
I know,
and and now they're just going, remember that game that you wanted to play last year or 2 years ago?
Tell me regardless of that. Killzone 2 was not amazing.
It looked good.
Amazing.
No, it wasn't amazing.
Well,
It was the best graphics of a first-person shooter I'd seen, but
I think and Call of Duty 2 looked like...
Call of Duty 4. Yeah. No. Yeah, but I'll say for me... I'm kind of done with the first-person shooter. I had so much fun with Gears of War.
Yeah.
And like Rainbow Six, I was like, I was sort of disappointed that it wasn't a third-person.
I'll tell you what happened to me this week, too. I got my 360.
Because it did look awesome. I mean, but it looked awesome 2 years ago.
I'm, like, not working right now, so I have a lot of free time, and I'm, like, really want to play video games.
Yeah.
And I went online, and I went to Blockbuster. I was, like, trying to, because I canceled my GameFly.
Yeah, remember that.
And I wanted to play. My favorite kind of game is third-person action. Prince of Persia, God of War. There's no game for me to play. That's why I asked if I could borrow your Cameo. Which do you have?
Jerry hasn't given it to me yet.
Curses. I really want to play that game, and 360 doesn't have that game
for me. Well, Assassin's Creed is going to be that game.
Yeah, but I got to wait freaking... I'm just saying, it sort of sucks that... It sucks that every game is a first-person shooter.
You recommend
The Darkness, so now I gotta freaking play The Darkness, but I will say, I rented Colin McRae, didn't really like it so much.
Let's talk about E3.
And what
Colin
I'm
McRae
gonna say is...
Dirt?
What?
Dirt or Colin McRae?
Dirt, sorry.
Oh. Well, that's the same thing.
Well,
it's starting to grow on me a little bit, but immediately I felt like MotorStorm looked so much better than Dirt. And that's why I was like, I want a goddamn PS3.
Yes.
I really want a PS3. I really want
Dirt
it.
Dirt is also on the PS3.
When do I buy it? Not now, I wait.
No, you
wait
buy it now,
games.
Baby.
No, wait
then
for
I
games.
Can have
don't
the money
to,
for the games.
Don't listen to moron who bought it 3 weeks before E3. And
I really want it.
I'm digging on it. Dude, it
when is the first game
I agree
out?
With you that
let's
the
talk
Sony
about
pref-
more games.
The Sony press conference got me more excited than either of the two press conferences.
Well, now, see, I didn't see the press conferences. I just watched the videos online. Ratchet and Clank looked amazing.
Amazing.
And the fact that there could be a Sly Cooper coming out with that kind of graphics?
Well, no, but the Sly Cooper guys are doing Infamous.
Infamous.
Which is
Infamous?
A superhero game where you can be either good or evil. It's like Crackdown GTA meets...
That's amazing.
City of Heroes.
No.
The footage, though... I don't even remember what I saw, but I remember the feeling that
cars
I had.
Cars flipping
at you. And he, like, ran up on a car in a very parkour-y way as well.
And it's the dudes who did Sly Cooper.
That's epic.
Yeah. Sucker Punch is the name of the group.
Echo Chrome? The best thing.
What?
Echo Chrome.
I disagree. I think so far the best thing I saw was actually Little People, Big World.
Little Big Planet.
That was where I actually went. I would get a PS3 for that.
Little Big Planet
Echo
is the
Chrome
reason
was just sort of like,
I bought my
you got
PS3.
It, you know what, though? Yeah, you looked at Echo Chrome like this, and when you see it in HD, it's this cool... Remember the Matrix, that white world in the Matrix where it was like him and the... It's like this really pure white and pencil drawing.
Phil Harrison introduced it as the least amount of graphics and the most amount of gameplay.
With you're that see. Intro was like
wow,
and it just the gameplay was.
It looked interesting.
Well, I will not be able to put that.
It's
down.
Like MC different. Escher the game.
Right. Yeah,
it's definitely something different that you've never.
I think it's like a Rubik's Cube. Or like Labyrinth. That
well, no, you know what it is?
It's gonna like be Lode Runner.
It looks like Lode Runner.
Well, kind of.
Kind of like Lemmings, more like to me. Like,
but it's, I think it's its own thing. It's its own thing.
Yeah. I love it. And Home, I'm like excited about Home.
I haven't seen Home.
Home is the.
I mean, I know. Saw the pre-Home. Did they put more stuff out?
Well, they have more. They had showed more rooms and how it's gonna work. And like the fact that we're gonna have a totally rad show room in Home.
I like it's cool.
Where people can go and meet, and we can do a live show kind of thing where we can be there and have our show being playing on it and hanging out with people.
We can all playing be talking. On the TV. We could take a picture right now on my cell phone, your iPhones.
That's the idea that you had at. Remember about live blogging from your like take a picture and it uploads.
I had an idea.
Yes, no, you did. You wanted to make a website.
That was me. I want to make a company.
I'm pretty sure it was Dan.
No, wait, I uploaded. And you could post it to the forums.
Yeah.
Instantly start a forum topic.
Yeah, they're doing that on PS3.
Yeah.
To forums on the web?
To the Sony website and in your home.
Oh, so it goes straight into your space all of a sudden. Yeah. Now here's the other thing now in Home, can you talk? Like I have a headset, so you're walking up to people and you can just hear their conversations and I go up. That's cool.
That's cool.
That's really
cool.
I would actually go talk to people.
I would.
Right.
One other thing about pictures that I have to say that got me so excited. They were talking about Burnout for Sony, although this may have been for the 360.
It's going to come out on both its lead platform as the PS3.
But here's the cool thing about it.
I'm very interested to see those two compared side to side if their lead platform was actually...
So far, I got to say, the Sony stuff, it does seem like it looks better to me than the Xbox. I don't know if it's power suggestion.
Well, theoretically, the power of the Sony is supposed to be, I mean, when they announced it, was supposed to be more slightly, but
if
still
you,
more
if you
powerful.
Designed
there's a
for
smoothness
it,
which is why
to
I
want to
see.
Well. There's like a smoothness.
Which is why I want to see Burnout running, because if it's truly designed lead platform for the PS3 and then ported down to the.
Yeah, we'll see.
Check like out what Burnout's got. Mugshot? Did you hear about Mugshot?
Yeah.
What?
This,
if
I
you
think.
You crash into somebody and you have a webcam.
No, or you lose or whatever.
It takes a picture of what you look like, and it gives you a second to, like, if you can.
It gives it one burst. It gives a burst, like when you're in a roller coaster and it takes the picture.
Oh, that's happening.
So when you're like, you're going no! You know, like snap the picture and you see your buddy so you get to make fun of.
That's
I think that
really funny.
Kind of thing, this is just the beginning. You know, like that kind of thing.
Yeah.
And Gears of War when we're together and it's like has the mugshot of when you just lost in multiplayer.
Yeah.
Or even just it shows you video of the guy for five seconds.
Or you can watch the person that you're like following. You can see them playing the game, you know?
And and it'd be cool if it's not like you have to hit record and it sends it. If the game does it automatically at key points, so you know that's the point where you do the thing.
Yeah.
Okay.
Awesome.
So we have a lot more stuff about E3 that we can talk about next week, hopefully. And this is just sort of the tip of the iceberg.
Yeah. But
the way I want to wrap the segment up real fast, if you guys could only play one game that you saw, if there's one game in the whole thing that you saw that you could play and you had to not play any of the others, Dan?
Echo Chrome.
Wow.
Hands down. Wow. Echo freaking Chrome.
Wow. I'll go Call of Duty 4.
Here's mine. I was going to do Call of Duty 4, and then Call of Duty 4 and Killzone 2 for me are like this.
Yeah.
But the one game that I know I will have the most fun with...
Mario Galaxy.
Little Big Planet.
Oh! I wasn't on the list.
I think Little Big Planet is going to be the most
fun. When they started
fun.
Building the stuff and then interacting immediately, because if you're like, dude, I'm going to build something. Although, again, I hate
it's
to say
about cooperative building.
It's going to be a lot of penises.
Jeff, think about Killzone, though.
They'll have filters.
I don't... The gameplay of the first one... was atrocious.
I agree.
And this seemed, I don't know if the gameplay looked really cool.
The gameplay looked pretty cool.
Regular gameplay.
I know, but there's something about the scope.
The amount of action. I liked Resistance. It's Killzone 2, actually.
No, but I mean,
the first Killzone wasn't very good.
Well.
I agree, but I really feel like they've thrown so much money at this, and it's not going to be not good. It's going to be good.
I don't know about that. But. That's the end.
but. Woo! Oh.
Okay, so the open mailbag in the forums on TRS.com.
You know, I know it's a yes, totallyradshow.com. Do we own TRS.com?
That's why I just said that.
Oh, we should buy that.
We should buy that.
Okay,
try to. All right, here we go.
So first question from Spinny.
Spinny.
Where is your favorite place in the whole world?
Wow. That's a very broad question.
I will start us off because I just read this question before you guys did.
Yes.
And say my parents, the house where I grew up, the basement. is where our TV was.
Mm-hmm. It's where first
nice. I love carpet. My bare feet on my carpet. Growing up, it's where the action figures were played with. It's where the
I feel
forts.
Like I can't see Dan. There you are.
It's where the action figures were played with. It's where the forts were built. It's where the movies were watched.
That's nice.
I was going to say New Zealand, but then
have you been
I was
to New Zealand?
Yes, I have.
And you liked it, huh?
Amazing, but that reminds me that my basement. We actually had a finished part and then an unfinished part, and the unfinished part was amazing because we'd skateboard down there. We had a little quarter pipe down there. We would bean each other with tennis balls, which was fun. Did that a lot.
Yeah.
Nunchucks, throwing stars, all that stuff was down there. Ping pong table.
Yes.
That was for me growing up.
Basements were like
basements.
I grew up in
California. I miss basements. California, no basements in California.
I never knew what a basement was.
It's very rare. Nope.
It's everyone's basement was like that's where like the stuff was.
Yeah.
When the ceiling it was like had this.
Yeah. You guys don't want to hear something crazy?
Yeah.
My dad is actually looking into how much it would cost to
build a basement.
Make a basement under his house.
Yeah.
It's the house I grew up in. It's like he would tunnel under the house.
My brother has a basement here.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. He has a basement.
I guess mine would be, mine's kind of boring. The only thing I can think of, I like to travel, but if I'm away from home too much, I like being, I'm kind of a homebody, so I like being home, playing video games. I have to get back when I'm.
My hair right here.
So you're home,
yeah.
Wherever that may be at the time.
Yeah, where my heart is.
All right, moving on.
Moving on.
You still got it right there.
What's your problem?
Magic Storm says, hello, guys.
Hello, Magic Storm.
I have seen you talk about games a lot, but I get the distinct feeling that you don't like RPGs that much.
What RPGs have
you played? Video games with pen and paper. Which ones do you like the best, and which one did you hate the most, and why?
A simple perusal of my gamer tag would yield the result that I have 1,000 gamer points in Oblivion. Played the
good.
Living poop out of
I
that game.
I didn't actually buy that game because I knew it would suck 60 hours of my life away.
Yeah.
I love RPGs. Eye of the Beholder was one of my first, love RPGs.
My favorite game of all time is Ultima 7.
That's interesting. Yeah.
I played Phantasy Star 3 when I was a kid on Genesis. I didn't enjoy the game that much, but I love the idea of it. I love the art.
The
I love
Japanese
the world.
RPGs are very specific. Like that whole, four party people and they go in turn and you see it, you know what I mean? Like all that stuff.
Old Final Fantasy.
Yeah, for me, I really like the role playing games where you are the person. KOTOR.
Fable. KOTOR. Was fun.
Fable, Fable's good. Yeah. Fable 2 is going to be awesome.
All right. Sparks asks, what movies have Alex and Jeff seen that Dan hasn't?
Wow, how
we were
I
just
don't
talking
know.
About.
There's a lot, I guess, I would think.
There's plenty.
Yeah.
It may sound like I know a lot of movies, but the light's blinking and everyone knows
things.
A lot of movies, just not everyone knows the same
We were just
ones.
Talking about one that you and I were quoting a bunch of, and we were like, you've never seen that?
Yeah.
Dan, what was that?
Oh, I just saw The Black Hole. That was
the Black Hole!
Saw it.
What did you think?
But a week ago.
Powerful, dude.
Well, but you should
I mean,
have seen
there's
it
some things
the
that are cool about it, but you can see all the wires. It's so bad. Dude. That was cool. That was
awesome.
Like, holy shit.
Dude, yes.
Okay, next question.
All right.
And it's about a black hole.
Oh, you guys have talked about The Sopranos, Deadwood, The Shield, etc. What other cable shows do you guys like?
Used to like Rescue Me. This season actually stopped watching it.
Yep.
Cable shows.
Flight of the Conchords.
Flight of the Conchords is very specific.
My new favorite comedy.
It's very specific comedy, but it is really,
Little People,
really good.
Big World?
Little People, Big World
yes.
is
I watched
epicosity.
All the top shows. So you think you can dance?
Dude,
awesome.
Top Chef? Top Chef on Bravo?
Yeah.
Yes, love that.
I watched all of them.
Yeah.
Unwrapped, I mentioned that before.
And,
I know I couldn't think of the name of it.
With the D&D guy?
I used to watch Even Stevens.
yeah, which is where you started to get boofed.
All right, what's the next question?
What are the guys' opinions of American adaptations of Asian horror?
Good, usually. Like Ring?
Ring.
The Ring was
pretty good.
But
The Eye?
The Grudge
was it
atrocious.
Eye? Was it called The Eye?
The Eye was cool, yeah.
I like The Grudge. It scared me enough.
Well, The Eye
was
a remake.
Was
they're remaking The Eye right now, and I think he's asking what American...
The Eye was still Japanese.
Yeah,
right.
Well, it was
right.
Thai.
Thai, no.
Yeah, it's Thai.
Thai or Korean?
It's not Korean.
Okay.
The best of those that is being remade right now is A Tale of Two Sisters. It's Korean.
Yeah.
Tale of Two Sisters is awesome. That's the... And it's not these torture movies that you're opposed... It's like totally
slow
burn.
Well, the world is kind of going about it. I mean, Hostel 2 went down in flames. I mean, it's not like... I think those movies aren't making money anymore. So
we're trying to get one more.
Captivity, he mentions too, is like kind of like the cappers, but the last one of those that we see.
Well, cool. That was epic.
Yeah.
Okay.
Forum.
Well, what were you going to say?
I say one more. We got one more.
All right.
We're getting the finger.
Good work, guys.
This finger. Well, that's the show, folks.
It was a good one.
It was a good one. I remember back when we were talking about stuff and things. And
I enjoyed eating
and
ice
stuff.
Cream. Mm-hmm.
Did we do that in this episode?
Yes.
Did we?
I don't know. I remember eating it.
We must have.
We must have. Now it's been said.
E3, man.
Dude, I'm excited. Well, I think Dan and I are very close to getting a PS3. Very close. Not there yet.
I'm basically getting one.
You know, it's interesting.
That's awesome. I love it.
I'm not there yet.
Soon.
And the fact that you're doing that makes me want to do it less.
Sony FT-MFW.
Yeah, I mean...
Well, yes.
I think, you know, what he said, the guy who... One of the Sony guys. Sony Guts. That they showed a lot of games. I think it was Trettner, the other dude.
Who was very charming, I have to say. Jack Trettner, he came on, he was kind of self-deprecating. Yeah. And like,
a little too much.
How would you not be self-deprecating? You run Sony's PlayStation 3 division.
Well,
but you can't get on there and be like, I rock, and I know it.
Well, that's what they did last
year. I know. They shouldn't have.
He kept on saying that we plan to be on the market for 10 years. We plan for the future.
Yeah.
And I'm starting to buy that a little bit now. Like, their system has the power to be current in the future.
I can't imagine it's going to be 10 years before we see another system from Sony. I think
didn't the PS2 last 10 years?
It's
not
like
10 years.
I think we're on year 7 now, something like that. 5, 6, something. I don't know.
All I'm saying is I think as soon as PS3 started to clearly be as successful as it was, they all went, PS4, let's make sure we do it right. And they started working.
We'll see.
I think that's what
they You know what's
did.
Interesting to me? I one of my favorite... gaming-related blogs is Dubious Quality, this blog that Bill Harris writes. And he pointed out something that I thought was a very astute observation. He said, what E3 has proven to me is that the new, like, toned-down mini E3 doesn't really matter. Like, none of the big three...
It didn't seem toned-down and mini at all.
Well, but none of the big three made any announcements, really. I mean, there was,
Nothing huge.
Back in the day, this was the place where you'd break news, and now they all have their own events that they do, and that's where they want to really... unleashed because they have complete control over
the
news cycle.
Yeah.
Exactly. No, they're not competing for space with all this other stuff. So, unfortunately, it looks like E3, as fun and as exciting as it was, it really isn't what it used to be.
Well, that's pretty clear. But we'll go next year.
Yeah.
Maybe. Someone invites us. EA. Anybody? Hello?
Activision.
Please.
Activision. Anybody? We'll even take Activision. No, I'm just kidding. I was thinking Acclaim when I said that, by the way. So if you want to email us, I know we hit the forums before, but if you want to send in an email or if you want to send in a background...
Yeah, like Josh
like
did.
Josh Estes did,
yeah.
Please feel free to send them at fans@totallyradshow.com. That's fans@totallyradshow.com. Dan's hand?
Estes. They make the models, the model rockets we talked about a few episodes back. That's what Estes is. They make model rockets.
I'm not entirely certain we're pronouncing his name correctly.
Estes? Emilio?
Estevez? Oh, it's Estevez. It's not Estes. No. But rockets.
Yes.
Go to our website, www.totallyradshow.com. That's where the forums are. You saw a bunch of stuff we talked about in the forums. Go there. Sign up.
Hang out.
We love talking.
Chat
Things
skis.
Happen.
Yeah.
We enjoy it.
Head over to MySpace. Ooh. MySpace.com/totallyradshow. Where we will be reminding you not only when this episode is coming out, but also about Comic-Con.
Yep.
Where
basic.
We will be.
Where we will be.
Basic.
Bar it's, Basic.
Bar Basic at 8 p.m. is when everybody's going to start getting there. We're probably going to get there a little bit closer to 9, but 8 p.m. is when we're going to is when everybody's going to be heading down there. And we're going to try to get a section roped off, but we don't know yet. So get there early.
I am so excited about that. I'm so excited about the meetup that we're doing.
Yeah.
I'm excited about Comic-Con. I think it's going to be cool to hang out with the iFanboy guys and, like, meet all the people that can go down to Tandiego and meet us. It's
Dude, I love Tandiego.
Tandiego is like, there you go.
It's right next to
San Diego. Some color.
All right, well.
Also, we should thank the guys from iPhoto.
Yes, iStock Photo guys were here.
They hung out with us.
They sweated the bullets
Dane
with us.
Dane and Jason.
Yes.
Yeah. Awesome.
And they may have peeked
And they agree with me on Footloose, by the way.
Oh, well. Who could not? Yeah. Well, that's it for this week's edition of the Totally Rad Show. I'm Alex Albrecht.
That's Dan Trachtenberg.
That is Alex Albrecht and Jeff Cannata.
Until next week, keep it rad, San Diego.
Mahalo.
Really? Really?
Spooky noises!
This house is so not clear.
Rolling in that will give me a reason to forget.
I love you.
Yeah, go.
You rolling?
Yeah.